IPL T20 2016. It's the Knight Riders taking on the Tridents from the Queen's Park Oval. The toss was won by the Tridents captain Kyron Pollard, and he elected to field first. Confirmation of the teams as they lined up for the Knight Riders. First of all, they were happy to have the services of Brendan McCullum, fantastic servant of New Zealand cricket over his career, now taking part in the CPL. And a little bit down the list, you have Hashim Amla out of South Africa, who is a fantastic player in his own right across all formats, and another key player for the Knight Riders, Darren Bravo, after his performances in the CPL last year and what he did in the first game. For the Tridents, they would have a few key players of their own as well, and that would be led by AB de Villiers, who is on his CPL debut. Outstanding for South Africa at all levels, in all versions. Another man to keep your eye on, Shoaib Malik, who's been a leading run scorer for the Tridents over the three editions of the CPL, and a man making a return to this level of cricket, Nicholas Pooran, hard-hitting left-handed wicket-keeper batsman. At the top of the action, our first set of commentators were H.G. Ackerman and Damian Martin.
McCullum, what a force he is. Look at those numbers, 242 games, but that's the strike rate, 137, 158, in his debut in the IPL. He started that competition off with a bang. Let's play, and Parnell will start. Wow, that's the McCullum. The other night, it was surprising, he actually blocked a few and hit the ball back, and I think maybe tonight he might unleash, but as you mentioned there, Parnell does swing the ball. Now to Amla. It's true. That's Amla, we know. In the first boundary of the night.
The ball just has to be outside the off stump for Amla to recognise that there's a little bit of width. It's not a poor delivery by any stretch of the imagination, but he's got such good hands, the ability to hit the ball on the up. Graceful Amla.
He's got him. There it is. The first game spin and the second game for him. Bold. Going for the big sweep shot, McCullum. What a huge wicket for the Tridents.
Game two, and still no impact for McCullum for the Knight Riders. Not a great deal of turn, you can understand it. It's the new ball, it just slides on to leg stump. McCullum looking for the big shot over the leg side where there's no protection. And the Tridents have a big one. McCullum goes for one, it's 7-1.
Through, inside edge. Parnell holds his head, but it's going to be another boundary.
Unlucky for Wayne Parnell. Fine leg up in the circle. Inside edge, there's nothing that can be done. Four may go on the score sheet for Colin Munro, but Parnell will feel that's a little victory.
It's got him again. The left arm spin. Through the gate. Bold McCullum. And now Munro's gone tonight again. Off stump, knocked back.
The young man Hussain, no turn again, just goes across the left-hander. Munro plays inside it, and the two big hitters from New Zealand, they're gone. Now the Knight Riders, they find themselves in a spot of bother, and it's the left-arm spin with a new ball that's doing all the damage. Munro goes for six, it's 15-2.
Appealed. He's given him now. There was a pause. There was nerves, and the crowd's gone silent. The Knight Riders in all sorts of trouble. Their big gun, the man they love, Bravo's got to go.
They're in a mess now. The Trinbago Knight Riders are in an awful mess here. Runs it across the left-hander again. It's the open face. It's a good delivery, actually. Just finds the outside edge. Simple catch behind. Rampol does what he does best. He knocks people over. He's got a big one in Darren Bravo. Three down now. Bravo gone for four with just 20 on the board.
Swag is gone. Two and one over. He's off, Ravi. Pollard chasing him. The crowd is stunned. What is happening? Look at him. Three wickets down. Four. Even I'm losing it. Atmel, he says it all. He's got to go. Ravi's back.
Just a good length delivery. There's a little bit of width, and Akmal's just walked to the wicket. It's a lovely catch behind as well, diving to his right. Two in the over. They're in an awful mess, saw the Knight Riders. Akmal doesn't even bother troubling the scorers. He goes for naught. It's 20 for four.
End of the power play, six overs completed, 25 for four. That will help, not deliberate, but a welcome boundary, and this crowd will cheer it.
Take them any way they come, times like these. Dwayne Bravo just looking to unlock the offside. It's not very heavily patrolled at the moment. And that's a terrific shot. So strong there. It's just a flash of the blade, a flick of the wrists. And the ball disappears like a tracer behind square.
He bowls little cutters, David Visa, so he'll want his line to be a little bit straighter. He's bowling to a teammate of his internationally, Hashim Amla. There you can see him pulling his fingers down, but he just gave it too much width. Just one for that lovely shot. Ashley, so what would be your plan in terms of the lines you're attempting to bowl to Amla and Bravo?
Try to bowl as straight as possible. Try to use the biggest side of the ground. I'm knowing Trinidad, he's a bit low sometimes, so hopefully he'll get some variation from the wicket.
Thank you very much for your time, Ashley.
Yeah, thank you.
So we'll all be looking, if Ashley bowls another over, looking to see how straight he bowls, because that edge from Bravo that you talked about, that gave a little bit of width and went for four, the field that Pollard set is for straighter lines. Now that's the ball that he did not want to bowl. He talked about bowling straight. He got too straight the ball before and overcompensated. He went too wide. It's well played by Amla.
Ten overs gone, the partnership continues, 55 for four, the Knight Riders. And now it's time for the Buster Driggs break.
So these guys were doing moves that Bish and I couldn't even dream of. Buster move.
Speak for yourself. Nice pull shot, nice pull shot. Really good from Bravo. Much more required is what they'll be seeing.
Class. We used to see Bravo coming at the end and swinging himself off his feet almost, but he's batted well. He's got in early. He was in the fifth over. And that's a top order shot. Quality. That's what they need. We talk about getting their innings going. What's going to happen the next five overs?
Kilo Sen has been singing his own song. Oh, lovely. What use of the hands. Wonderful use of the hands from Amla.
It's a pleasure to watch. You're sitting at home and wanting to know about where to hit a ball, how late. He hits it late. And then the wrists come through. Class. Just I never get tired of watching him back. Offside, that cover around to backward point. He's so strong. A couple of boundaries now coming. One last over from Bravo. One for Amla. Good fielding. All the fun and excitement about the Caribbean and the cricket in this region. Everybody loves it. CPL for 2016. Oh, he's got him. Oh, the batting partner, Bravo. Just cops one on the leg. That brought up the 50 partnership. Good partnership, they came in early. Early wickets, this one, it's like, get me out of the road. Yeah, Bravo was in the fifth over. 20 for four, they were. A good turnaround.
Oh, lovely. The use of the feet made that for Bravo.
Hero Maxman. That's where he hit him last year as well. Giving himself some room, they love it. Flags are flying, they're dancing. Captain Bravo. Ah, oh, that's beautiful. That's where you hold your shot a bit more. Yeah, that's what the bowlers don't want, Bish. Not that you got hit for six too often.
Very often. And Bravo was eyeing up that long off strike. He hits the ball inside out very well because it was a mid off. He's now pushed back to long off and fine leg has come up.
The horse, Bish. It's between the horse and the frog.
Oh, that is sweet, sweet, sweet from Hashim Amla. Hero maximum. 90 for four.
Busting moves everywhere. It's hot now with Amla. What a shot that was. I've seen some classy shots from him, but a six over cover. It's quite remarkable. Making their fight and their comeback at the moment.
They've come to life.
They were dead silent after about five or six overs. Their team were in an awful mess, but they scrapped hard. And so the beaters returned and the smiling faces and the belief that their side can get off the mark in this Hero IPL. CPL for 2016.
Four. Just out of reach and 50 for Hashim Amla. Longest part of the ground, Hashim Amla. May have just thought he picked out the fielder at deep square. The umpires are going to have a little look at as to whether or not that's gone all the way for six, but it's again a glorious piece of timing, fabulous piece of placement.
Oh yes from Amla, a hero maximum. so, so good. Real appreciation of the art of batting from Hashim Amla. He's got the touch. He can open the face, he can glide the ball around, but when he needs to, he can also get that front leg out of the way and crunch it over the fence.
And then how about that? That's very clever. That's another big one for him.
Reigning hero maximums here. Hashim Amla has put his foot to the floor. And the floor is beginning to shake here at the Queen's Park Oval.
Hundred partnership for Dwayne Bravo and Hashim Amla.
And that's going to be another boundary. Wayne Parnell is getting the treatment from his teammate. South African compatriot is going the journey. 17 gone, 124 for four.
Parnell had gone for 15 off three and was probably thinking it was his night until Amla took 20 off his last. Chance for Pollard, back pedaling. No, not going to get there.
Oh, that looked nasty. That looked really nasty. Kyra Pollard has had knee surgery. He's had to work unbelievably hard to get himself back fit so that he could play for the Mumbai Indians in the IPL. Missed out on the World T20 because of it. Such a big man. And with the ground soft underfoot here. Oh, dear. Ankle, Achilles, you name it, all in trouble there.
This is gone. Miles. Another hero maximum, this time for Bravo.
He pinned his ears back there. Absolutely nothing left behind in this stroke from the captain, Dwayne Bravo. Another slow ball from Visa. The bat doesn't come down early. Absolutely no trickery there from Visa. Bravo wasn't fooled in the slightest. He has absolutely leathered it out of the park.
It's all Pollard as well, just trying to dry the seam. It seems as though the ball is getting a little bit wet now. Down again! Oh yes! 50 for the captain! What an innings!
Second 50 in the CPL, and well might the coaching and mentoring staff be on their feet.
Very well bowled. Very well bowled. They'll get two, you know.
Oh, that's a magic moment. That is a magic moment. Hashim Amla with a huge grin on his face. I wonder how long it's been since he's played French cricket.
Got all of it. You bet he has. That's another big one for Bravo. And it takes them past 150.
Watch this. Still balanced, even though the swing is a violent one. Still keeps his balance, still has that firm base where all the power comes from.
Out of reach and away for four. That's a delightful stroke by the captain. It ends the 19th. They're in good shape, 158 for four. De Villiers is not even in the game. That's way back from Umla. Malik just missed his length, and away it went.
Well, got past the highest score in the competition this year. We're only three games in, of course. Hashim Amla has absolutely smeared this one out of the park.
Well, they finish with a flurry. They certainly have the last three overs.
Bowled him. Malik strikes with a final one, but Amla's done some damage. 81 he finishes with. Bravo's unbeaten on 66. The partnership is 150. 170 for five, the highest total for CPL 2016 has been achieved here at the Queen's Park Oval tonight.
Well, I'm down here now with Hashim Amla after a beautiful 81 night out, and let me tell you, it looked like you really enjoyed it, mate. Tough start early on, wasn't it?
Yeah, listen, they bowled very well up front. We obviously lost four very quick wickets, and it picked us back quite a bit. I was just grateful that myself and DJ got a partnership together, and we managed to get at least a defendable score at least.
.170 for 5, Bravo unbeaten on 66. Amla bowled off the final delivery of the innings for 81 of just 54 deliveries. Bear in mind, they were 20 for 4. It's the first time ever in CPL that there's been a 100 partnership for the fifth wicket.
Well, the bowlers were having a wonderful evening until the Bravo and Amla show. Hussain picked up a couple of wickets early, bowled brilliantly, 2 for 18 for him. Ravi Rampal had 2 wickets in an over, and 1 point was 2 overs, 2 for 6, but he got a bit of treatment towards the end. David Visa, they got stuck into him. Shoaib Malik, well, he only had the one over, it was the final one. Picked up the wicket of Amla with 1 for 12.
Well, Tridents have never beaten the Knight Riders at the Queen's Park Oval. If they want to change that, they need 171 to win off 120 balls, the 20 overs that are allotted to them. It should be fun.
Here we go, slow left arm to open the bowling. Ready for a big run chase.
Oh, that's gone miles up. It's gone straight up in the air. Three fielders converging on it. One's fallen over, another's hit the deck, and the Tridents have come back for two.
Wow, that's chaos. That's gone miles up in the air. Bang, second delivery. Watch them all go. Cooper says it's mine. And he falls short, but off screen. If we can get off screen, we'll see the sliding and the outfield's wet.
Right, slammed. McCullum's out there. Can't hang on. It's Monroe